Welcome to CITAM Church Online. This is Pastor Karita Mbagara, the Deputy Bishop of Christ is the Answer Ministries. Today, I want us to have a frank and honest talk about the coronavirus, which seems to have caused a lot of anxiety in our nation. But for those who know the Lord, they can turn to God and find rest. Psalms 91 seems to speak of a time like this. Verse 1 tells us, "Whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty." My brother, my sister, if you have put your trust and confidence in God, then you will rest. You will not be anxious. And you are called to put your trust in God, and God will take care of you. The Lord is the shadow that protects you from the dangers that would come. The psalmist here may have been thinking of sunstroke, but even now, God will be a shadow around you, will be a shield all around you against coronavirus. Put your faith and trust in Him. The other verse that I want us to look at is verse 5, which says, "You will not fear the terror of night, nor the arrow that flies by day." Here, it talks about fear, that we will not fear. When you have confidence in God, you have no reason to be afraid. And if fear comes, it should be the fear that helps you to take the necessary precaution and leave the rest to God, but not to live in fear, not to live in anxiety. Yes, God allows us to be cautious. And by that, I mean that He may allow us to be concerned so that we can take the necessary actions that are, humanly possible. But we leave the rest to God, because you are not sure. This is not something you can see. If somebody passed by and left the virus maybe on a desk, you are not sure on that. Yes, you may sanitize yourself, but it may just be a small moment that this happens, or a very brief moment that this happens. But let's put our trust in God. Let's not allow fear to paralyze us. This psalmist continues to tell us that God will command His angels so that they will guard us. That is in verse 11. And I want to believe that even as we ask God to take care of us, that He has sent His help. He has sent His angels. The Bible tells us in the book of Hebrews chapter 1 verse 14 that angels are ministering spirits for those who are to be saved. If you're a child of God and you have given your life to God, I want to assure you that God has sent His angels to watch over you. And you could also, pray that prayer, "Lord, send your angels to watch over my loved ones, members of my family," and God will do that. It continues to tell us that we will be able to tread on the lion and the cobra. You will trample the great lion and the serpent. That's verse 13. And it seems to be suggesting the imagery of a lion and a serpent in the Bible always is about the devil. And the devil attacks us in many ways. It could be the bringing of fear. It could be also that actually he is conniving and planning and intentioning, or has the intention to bring calamity your way. But the Bible tells us, because of our trust and our faith in God, we will be able to overcome this intention or this plan by the devil to destroy us. And I just want to encourage you, go and take time and read this Psalm, Psalm 91, and you will be assured and you will be able to overcome. The psalmist closed this Psalm by saying, because the believer has put his trust in God, then he will call and I will answer. Verse 15, "He will call on me and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. He will deliver him and honor him." God is going to hear your prayers. You have put your faith in Him. You are a Christian. You've been walking with Him. And all because of his grace and mercy, not because really you deserved it, I want you to take confidence from these words, that God will hear your prayers. But this also says that you need to pray. You need to call upon the name of the Lord, and he will come through for you. And we will be looking back in a few months' time and saying, God has been with us, and God has been good, because he's always good, and it can't be otherwise. Let me hear what you think about what I am saying, how it has helped you, how it has encouraged you, using the social platforms that are listed below. And may I encourage you also to share this message so that others can benefit from the truths that Psalms 91 gives to a Christian. God bless you.